Good morning, you're with Proactive Investors. Our very own Polly Middlehurst, she's in Glasgow for a packed out BRICKLIVE event in the city. Morning, Polly.
Thanks, Andrew. Yes, welcome to Scotland. Sunny Scotland, not so sunny today, actually, a bit drizzly. Everybody's inside. It's the start of the school holidays and BRICKLIVE Glasgow has opened. And let me tell you, it's packed. And with me, Chairman David Ciclitira and major shareholder Neil Cameron. Welcome to you both. David, if I can come to you first. A phenomenal success once again. You must be a very pleased man.
Yeah, I'm delighted. I came here last year when we first had the first show in Glasgow. Ticket sales are very good. We'll have thousands of people here over the weekend, which is fantastic. Great that the weather's what it is, because they come here as opposed to, I don't think they have beaches in Glasgow. But anyway, it's very, very successful. Lots of people here today.
School's out for summer, of course, Neil, and you're here with your family as well as being a major shareholder. It's an event that your family's interested in.
Yeah, that's right, Polly. Yeah, so I arrived here at 3 o'clock yesterday. I walked through the door. My nephew said to me, it's amazing. It's way better than he thought it was going to be. You can see from the show as you go around, it's not just about Lego. There's the whole interactive element. There's all the gaming stations. There's all the warrior bots. There's so much for people to do, young and old, children. It's just an amazing all-round experience. And as a shareholder, the wow factor coming through the door really sort of brought it home to me.
David, is Neil touching on the magic of this show there by describing that moment when you walk through the door? It's really difficult to capture on camera, isn't it?
Yeah.
The expanse of what's available to the kids and parents here today.
There is a lot more than what you realise, and you're right. There's lots of different elements, and you've got to remember, this isn't our biggest show. So if you went to Birmingham, I think it's three times the size. So this is a medium-sized show with lots of different elements. But he touched on the wow factor. I go back to when I first got involved with BRICKLIVE, sort of 18 months ago. What sold it to me was when I walked in the room and I saw so many happy faces, so many concentrated faces, so many parents with kids. Screen light, totally. I know there is interactive games, but how many children, grandchildren do we have that basically live on that telephone? This is educational. It's absolutely interactive.
Neil, isn't it great to see kids not absorbed in their screens for once and to be interactively playing with Lego in this concentrated way?
No, absolutely. I think that's really important. I think also building on the educational element, there's the BRICKLIVE Animal Paradise, there's BRICKLIVE Touring. We're seeing these animals. Some of these are endangered species. I think through the power, the medium of the BRICKLIVE experience, children understand that. Maybe they can do something about it in the years going forward. I think it's very powerful. And all the kids I see are completely engrossed in it and they're loving it, as are the parents.
And talking a little bit more, if we may, David, about that educational dimension to these shows, that's particularly why it's been such a big hit in Asia. Tell us what's happening in Bangkok.
Bangkok is actually a normal show. It's a show about the size of this. It's in Bangkok. It launches on Thursday next week. But we've also got an Animal Paradise show in Busan. Busan is the second city in Seoul. That launches on the 1st of August. We've got another show with animals in Argentina taking place now. So there's a lot going on. But I'd like to take you back. Yesterday we launched and released news of our biggest ever activity, which is going to be in Beijing. September the 7th, we're launching a 20-city tour across China over 3 years. It is a show that is based on 80 animals, Animal Paradise. As Neil has said, it's educational elements. We're publishing books. We do all kinds of things to educate children about the importance of the endangered species. So it's not just bricks, it's education.
Tell us why those Asian parents are lapping this up and you're able to do such a phenomenal tour across China, David.
Well, I think it's also, it's just not the parents, it's also the schools. Because in China, we're going to 20 cities and in every city, we're dealing with not just the Tourist Bureau, which is obviously keen to bring visitors there, but we're dealing with the educational bureaus. So when we're able to say that 50,000 kids, parents will come minimum to each show, that's because each city has committed to put it into the school curriculum. So that's an amazing success. We'll have 1 million people coming to see these shows.
And Neil, when you hear those numbers, of course you're a major shareholder, your money's obviously in the right place.
Definitely feels like the money's in the right place, and as I say, with the expansion of the different brands, and I've been seeing it for myself this week, I couldn't be happier with my investment.
So your 8-year-old nephew is here today. He was absolutely fanatical about Warrior Bots. What do you think he likes best about the show? And indeed, your sister-in-law coming here too as well.
Yeah, they both had a wonderful time. I mean, interestingly, my sister-in-law is really a keen Lego builder. It's probably, she's been reintroducing that through her son, through my nephew. For him, it's about the PlayStation, the Nintendo, the gaming experience with the Lego characters, Marvel figures, Star Wars, all the superheroes. He loves it. I mean, for them, it's just like, this is just like the perfect day out for them. So they both really had a great time.
That's the way to put it, really, David, isn't it? The perfect day out for kids and parents.
Yeah, well, it's also great to have a shareholder, someone who's supported this for a long time, come and see it. Because I think, if I'm right, this is the first time you've been to BRICKLIVE. And it's very easy to see the videos, it's easy to see the website. But I think coming in is something completely different. So, we have a show, end of October, half term. Biggest show we do, actually, in Birmingham at the NEC. We had a very interesting dinner with some of Neil's colleagues earlier in the week. I'm going to say now that I would like very much to host a dinner for other shareholders to come to the NEC at the end of October. Because I think, Neil, I think if some of your colleagues saw what we saw today, we don't want them to necessarily buy more shares, but we want them to love what they bought.
And that show, David, actually, it's the first weekend in November, I believe.
Yes, it's half-term week.
That's right. That is going to be three times what we see here today.
It is three times the size, yes.
Tell us how many
35,000-40,000 people.
Got any more numbers for me? Thousands of people attending?
Thousands? No, it's 35,000-40,000 was last year. I think it was 38,000 came last year. So that's, and this is the third year we'll be doing it in Birmingham. So
in terms of your company's growth and forward planning, looking to the future, you've given us a hint of what you've got in the pipeline. Your trajectory looks like it's on the up and up. We're looking at a hockey stick here, aren't we?
All I've done so far is to tell you what we have released. We do, you're quite right, have a lot in the pipeline, which will be released. I think the key message for me to shareholders, and I think Neil and I have chatted about this earlier today, this is the year where you're building. So if you think we only went public in just after Christmas, just before Christmas last year, the company is only 16 months old. This is a year where we are developing new projects. Animal Paradise is a perfect example. The idea was thought about at the beginning of January, and here we are doing it in 2-3 major cities around the world already. So it's about a development year, and I think what I think Neil has hopefully understood today is that underneath what you see on the surface, there's a great deal of value in what's being built. I think that's what we've discussed most of the day.
Neil, would you agree with that?
No, absolutely, 100%. As I said, I couldn't be more impressed. I've seen some of the stuff that's in the pipeline that the guys are talking about, some of in the design stage. It's very exciting. I think, as you mentioned, the company's definitely on an upward trajectory. I've been so impressed. I met David in February, and since then my shareholding has grown significantly.
You tripled your shareholding. Let's be straight here.
I've tripled my shareholding since February, and coming to this only really further emphasises that I've made the right decision, and yeah, I can be happy with where the brand's going. Well,
David, just, sorry.
I would just like to thank Neil, because he's been a great supporter, and there are like-minded supporters. And I said once, I think maybe even to you, that it's a bit like Barcelona Football Club. We're owned by the fans. I'm a shareholder, he's a shareholder. We're all shareholders. This is a common journey that we're on.
Just lastly, David, from you, where do you see the company in 5 years, 10 years from now?
My goodness. Well, in 5 years' time, we will definitely be a significant... Well, we are a brand, a global brand, but we will be a significant global brand. I think we will have developed lots of things, and I'm sure our partnerships around the world will have grown. Obviously, the profit line will have grown. But I think the value of the company... I'm all about overall value, and I think it will be a... Maybe we started with something small, but it'll be much more significant.
Right, the fun starts now. The business questions are over. What have you got planned for the rest of the day, Neil?
Me? I'm heading off to Carnoustie after this. I'm hoping to see Rory McIlroy win the Open Championship. So I've had a wonderful 2 days here, but I'm now ready to go and see some sports. So then I go up to Scotland to see my brother up to Scotland in Inverness. See the rest of my family.
You take your suit up for Carnoustie?
Of course.
Bloody freezing up there.
David, what are you going to be doing for the rest of the day?
Actually, I'm going home back to London tonight. But I've been to the Open many times, and what I remember about the Open is it's always colder than you believe.
Yes.
It's Scotland.
Gentlemen, thanks very much indeed. See you both in Birmingham. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, Polly.
Well, that's all from us here at BRICKLIVE in Glasgow at the SEC in Scotland. Back to you in the studio, Andrew.
That's great, Polly. Polly Middlehurst there in Glasgow at a buzzing BRICKLIVE. And of course, a busy time for them, not just in Glasgow. I've caught up a number of times in the last couple of weeks with David Ciclitira. As he touched on there, plenty to look forward to. Just a handful of some of the events we can look forward to. Of course, in September, there's that three-year 20-city BRICKLIVE Animal Paradise show that they're rolling out throughout China, as well as the recent announcement around the launch of BRICKLIVE Monaco Christmas at the end of this year. So an exciting few months ahead for BRICKLIVE.